Hello there and welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com, teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian and today I'm here again with a quick tip on how you can make better use of Google Tag Manager in combination with Google Analytics. And this is really when you want to get more information apart from the Tag Assistant here to view what information went out to the Google Analytics tracking code or to Google Analytics itself. And this is normally done with the GA debugger. That's an extension for Chrome that you can activate and it will give you great information here inside of our developer console. You can reach that by going to More Tools and then your developer console. And under the console log, you will be finding a lot of information of what information was actually sent over to Google Analytics. This will give you great information to debug if you have any kind of events firing and you want to make sure that the right data is going over, or if you find out that some data is corrupted, you can look into this log and see what each page view or each event is sending over to Google Analytics. Really a great addition to debugging our toolset within Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics. Now, there is this extension out there that you can install, but there's actually another trick to make this work every time you have the preview and debug mode open. And this is simply putting your Google Tag Manager, Google Analytics tag into a special state. And you can find that under the override settings here of our Google Analytics tag. You can go to More Settings. Down below, we have Advanced Configurations. And here we have a field called Use Debug Version of Google Analytics. If we set this to true, we should see the same information in the console. Now, notice I don't have the GA debugger turned on right now, and we get all this information. If I obviously turn this to false, it will not show me this information. Now, the cool thing that you might have already seen is that we'll be able to utilize variables here to see whether it should be turned true or false. And we can utilize a variable that we need to activate first in our variable menu. It's a built-in variable, and this is simply the variable called debug mode. It's under errors for whatever reason. But this will simply determine whether our Google Tag Manager is in the debug mode or not. So if we reload this page and look into our variables, we can look here in the debug mode and it's right now true. Now, if I would leave the debug mode, it would turn into false. Now, it's safe to assume everybody who has that debug mode open is a marketing manager or a developer or somebody who is trying to debug something in Google Tag Manager. And therefore, at this stage, I always want to turn on our Google Analytics debug option in the developer tools. And we can simply do this by going into our tag, and in that option that we just ticked, we'll not use true every time, but rather our debug mode variable. So every time Google Analytics is opened and firing a tag, it will either be put into the debug mode or into the normal state, depending if the preview and debug mode is actually open. So right now we see our data here. So if I leave the preview and debug mode, go back to our page and reload that, and we see nothing in the console. We see still that Google Analytics is being deployed, but the debug mode was turned off because we don't have the actual preview and debug mode from Google Tag Manager open. Now, obviously, you don't want to do this for all your different tags. Like if you have a Google Analytics event click trigger, you want to utilize this option in your Google Analytics settings variable. So if you have a settings variable set up, I'm just going to inherit this from the settings variable. You can also go into your settings variable that you have set up. I have one right here. And set the option in the More Settings under the Advanced Settings. And here, use the debug version. Yes, only if the debug mode is true. Let's save this. And henceforth, if you go into the preview and debug mode, and a Google Analytics tag fires, we should see in our JavaScript console the debug information from the Google Analytics tracking code. Hey there, it's me again. Thanks for checking out our quick tip video. Was that helpful? Did you understand something? Not quite? Then I'd love to hear from you in the comments down below. But if you liked it, then why not give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel right over there, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.